Today we're going to talk bald eagles with conservation biologist Sandra Johnson. I'm Mike Anderson with the North Dakota Game and Fish Department. Sandra, give our viewers the history of bald eagles nationally and in North Dakota.
So the bald eagle was removed from the threatened and endangered species list in 2007. So when we look back through history, the bald eagle really started declining throughout the 1900s, and that's why it was added to the endangered species list in 1978. And since it was removed, the bald eagle has really been increasing both nationally and in North Dakota.
Give the history of bald eagles in North Dakota.
So historically, bald eagles did nest along the Missouri River, Red River, probably Devil's Lake area, Turtle Mountains. And then when populations really declined throughout the 1900s, we didn't really know of many nests. In the 1970s and 80s, there were probably less than three nests in the state. And then through the 1990s, they started increasing. By 2010, we had almost 100 nests in the state. 2020, we're at about 300 nests. So in just the last 10 years, we've tripled the number of active nests in the state.
Historically, most of our bald eagle nests in North Dakota were along river corridors. That's not the case.
Well, they've proven to be quite adaptable, and they will nest in trees, out in the middle of pastures, in the middle of fields, really anywhere where they've got a food source nearby, and it doesn't necessarily have to be water either. Nationally, there's some bald eagle nests that are more than 9 miles away from any type of water source. So eagles really are one of the top predators, and if there's a food source, if there's large trees and there's food sources, it could be potential bald eagle nesting habitat.
Why are bald eagles making such a big comeback?
So bald eagles declined in the 1900s because of a number of reasons. One, there weren't federal laws that protected them. Conservationists started working on protecting bald eagle habitat. They started increasing. So bald eagles are a really long-lived species. They'll live 30 years, and they don't start breeding until they're at least 5 years old, probably older. So because it's a species that takes quite a long time to mature, it just took that long. And now that it's increasing, it's just growing.
On a national level and on a local level, we're still monitoring bald eagles.
Yeah, so since the bald eagle was removed from the endangered species list in 2007, both the Fish and Wildlife Service and state wildlife agencies are continuing to monitor the population. So really what that means for North Dakota, what we're doing is just monitoring the number of nest sites that we have in the state. And one way we do that is asking the public to report bald eagle nests, and they can easily do that on our website. Since we have so many nests in the state, more than 300 active nests, it's really helpful for the public to go on and report what they've seen.
You know, and speaking of 300 nests, that's almost as many nests back when the bald eagle was put on the endangered species list that were in the entire country.
Mm-hmm. When the bald eagle was listed, there were less than 500 nests in the whole United States. And we actually, in our database, we have more nest sites that we've tracked. It's just bald eagles will often build a couple of nests and they'll use one. Or maybe a nest site is destroyed and they build a new one. So we actually have close to 500 nest sites that we have documented, but we think more than 300 are active at any one time.
Sandra, in addition to the nesting bald eagles that are in North Dakota, we also have eagles that migrate through our state.
Yeah, so now in March and April, especially when the snow geese start coming back, that's when we start seeing these larger groups of eagles around. So they're following food sources. And it's not uncommon to see 5, 10 or more eagles at any one time. They might be coming from the south, from Louisiana, other southeastern states. They could be coming from Minnesota, other states to our east or west. They're really just moving around, following food sources. And some of those adult birds might be going further north and nesting in Canada.
There's a lot of fun facts that most people probably don't know about bald eagles. When do they get their white heads? When do they mature?
Right. So bald eagles don't get that white head and white tail until they're about 5 years old. So the first year of an eagle's life, they're really dark. They look a lot like a golden eagle. The bald eagle also doesn't get that yellow beak until they're about 4 or 5 years old. So the beak coloration might be just dark until they get that white head.
A lot of people, like you said, think that juveniles are golden eagles. Is there a size difference, or how could you really tell if it's a bald eagle?
So juvenile bald eagles are actually quite large. They're actually larger than an adult bald eagle, because when birds are young, their feathers are actually longer. It just helps them have a little bit larger size so that they can learn how to fly better. But a bald eagle will have a 7-foot wingspan. So when they are flying in the air and you see this large bird and the wings are held very straight across, then you know it's a bald eagle.
Give us some fun facts about the bald eagle.
So a bald eagle nest can get quite large. The first year that they build a nest, it might be kind of small, but every year they keep adding on to the nest. And there are some nests now in North Dakota that we've been tracking for 15 years. And some of those nests are just huge in those trees. They can be up to 9 feet wide. Bald eagles also have very large wingspans that are up to 7 feet. Their foot strength is very strong, 10 times as strong as the strongest human hand. They also have very good eyesight. That's how they see their prey. So if you haven't seen one in North Dakota, this month, March and April, are really great times to get out, go for a drive, go find some larger lakes where there might be snow geese congregating and other birds, or places where there might be fish around. Those are great places to go out and see our nation's symbol. Just use caution when you're out looking at bald eagles. Don't walk up to them, don't disturb them, and recognize that a lot of bald eagles are on private land and they're also protected. So keep your distance when you're viewing eagles.
A lot of great information, Sandra. Thank you.